Hey, how you guys doing? I wanted to take an opportunity to attack a problem that a lot of people have. You get a tire that breaks off the rim or the valve stem goes bad, and a lot of times you have to take it to a tire shop because it's really hard to dismount these tires off of a rim, especially if you've got an agricultural tire, a heavy truck tire, or something like that. Or in this case, this tire is a tractor tire off of a Kubota tractor. And what happens is these tires are filled with a heavy fluid that keeps the tractor balanced, and it's just really heavy. The tire without the fluid is probably 30 pounds lighter, and it's all dirty. So I don't want to take it to the tire shop and try to do this. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to install a valve stem in through the front hole, which everybody says it can't be done, but I have done it in the past, and I wanted to make a little video here. So if you're ever stuck somewhere off-roading, or you're at your garage like me, I don't have a tire machine and I want to get this tire changed for my tractor without having to haul this into a tire shop and pay to do it. Valve stems are cheap. I have friends that just give me these at the tire shop. So I'm going to show you how to do this real quick. So basically what I did was I took a little oil and I actually put it around the actual valve stem, just kind of lube it up a little bit. But what I do is I take this and I force this down through here, and I get it in there, and I kind of just push it in piece by piece with a screwdriver. So I'm going to try to do it now so I can show you. Hopefully it works as easy as it does in the past. So what I do is I take a regular screwdriver. I take this down inside here. Let me see if I can get you over here where you can see a little bit better. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try to get this in through this hole here without having to take this off her. So I'm going to take this thing here. I'm going to actually push this down into the hole here. So what I do is I force part of it down in the hole. I kind of just rotate it down into the hole, and then I push this back part here, and I push the back corner in. So you see what that looks like right there. I think I'll zoom in a little bit more. Then what I do is I push this in a little bit more like that. Get this pushed in. I hold my finger on it like that. Push this in here a little bit more and just kind of work it down in slowly around the corners like that. Now you got to be careful you don't puncture the actual valve stem or your finger. So basically you're getting it down to looking, something like that. Let me see if I can show you. And then what you do is you just push this down in little by little. Just work that in. And then what I do is I go to this opposite side, and I just push that down in there. You see where I'm at on that now? And I just push that down in there like that. You pop this screwdriver out, and that's it. That's totally in there. It's not ripped. It's not torn in any way, you can look all around the bottom of the stem to see if it's torn. So, obviously you don't want to tear the bottom of that plunger off, but what happens is you can see that's completely in there, and you don't have to take off the rim. So that's basically how you do it. Just got to be careful you don't poke your finger. All right, good luck.